I'm Andrew Wasson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. In this lesson, I'm going to be covering one of the greatest guitar lick workouts of all time. It's going to include five guitar strings with a starting and ending note that targets the scale's root to really lock down on the major tonality sound. Technically, it's going to include four important guitar technique phrasing devices covering fret slides, hammer-ons, pull-offs, and string bending. After this, join me for the second half of the lesson over on my Patreon page, where I'm going to take the lesson's guitar lick and do two very important ideas with it. First thing is, I'm going to go and convert the lick from major over to minor, and then we're going to check out a scale shape that I made for you on guitar so that you can start to create your own licks using a custom jam track progression that I've composed and recorded just for this lesson. But first, before we get started, I have a quick word I want to share with you about my Handouts Collection ebook offer. Do you want an amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the CreativeGuitarStudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to CreativeGuitarStudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. This lesson is all about guitar lick training, and this topic is one of the most important parts of studying the guitar because it focuses on using scales and learning how to play lead guitar. Now, this lesson's guitar lick that I've composed for you is going to be initially viewed here as two separate sections, so it's going to be in two measures, and we're going to combine them to form a full two-measure guitar lick that covers five guitar strings across four fingerboard positions. Now, you'll want to practice this every day for around 3 weeks till you get it burned in, and then from there you're going to want to make this a regular part of your routine when you're practicing guitar to come up with new ideas and integrate them like this, because once you get into this format of doing this guitar lick practice, it's really going to make a huge difference in your playing. It'll literally change your guitar playing for the better. So let's get into the guitar lick, and like I said, it's going to be in two sections. The first section is like this here. I'll slow that down a little bit for you. It's covering F major. Here it is again, starting on the F on the 8th fret of the 5th string. It's just one streamlined blast of 16th notes, and you have to just sort of keep up with the motions there. There's a slide that happens in a couple of places, and then you got a hammer-on and a pull-off in there as well. I'll play it one more time for you. All right, so that's the first section. Let's go to the second section. It's got some bending that takes place with it. It sounds like this. Okay, I'll slow that down a little bit. So this one here is covering a couple more chords that would be passing by in the key. We'd have the A minor and then moving up to the B flat major. So it's like the third chord of the key moving up to the fourth chord. Now, what I'm going to do next is put both of those measures together so you hear what it sounds like as one big giant guitar lick. Okay, really nice sound, and the cool thing about it is it won't take you that long to learn it, but it will educate you in some really good ideas. You'll, you know, get the bending aspects together, the slides, hammer-ons, pull-offs. You can start incorporating vibrato like you heard me shaking on the string there on the last note. So you just got to take some time, put it in. You don't need a lot of time, but if you do it every day for maybe about 3 weeks, you'll really get it well integrated. However, we're not really done with the routine yet because I have a couple more layers to this that I want to share with you. Now, the next layer to it is taking this guitar lick and dropping it down from key of F to key of E. So we're taking it down a half step. Check it out. It's the same lick, but I'm just playing it down a half step. So So it's really the exact same thing, but I've just dropped it by way of a half a step on the neck. Now you're probably wondering, well, you know, what is this really going to do? I've already learned the lick in F, you know, from before. What does it do to take it down a half step? Well, for a lot of people who are learning guitar, a lot of times how you memorize the line and you get it all sorted out on the fretboard is by the fret look and the fret position, maybe the marker dots, what it feels like under your fingertips. And when you change positions, it just kind of can throw you off. So it's a really good idea to take licks and move them to other areas of the neck. Now I'm going to slow this lick down, play it one more time for you so you can just check it out. Here it is. All right, so that is just down a half step. But what if we took it to a totally different place on the guitar? Here it is again, but it's up the neck in the high register. Check it out. Okay, I'll play it again. So now I've taken it up to A flat major. We've done it now in three places. We've played it for F, E, and also A flat. So we've had a chance now to cover it in three different keys. You could do other work with your licks as time goes on. I'd probably suggest with some cases, if it's a short lick and it's simple, you could even just move it chromatically down the neck. It's really helpful to get the position shifts. In the case of the last one we just did, it's taking it from the middle of the neck where we have a certain space between the frets, and we've taken it to the upper register where we have the frets being really close together. So the way that your hand has to operate to create the lines and, you know, think about how all the notes are going to be laid out and what the feel of that is like, it's going to definitely change. So anyway, guys, this is like basically the first half of my lesson plan for you. I hope that you'll join me next on Patreon. Just go over to patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And over there, what I'm going to be doing is taking this guitar lick, this exact lick, and we're going to change the tonality of it. So right now, we've been learning it in major here on YouTube. But when we get to Patreon, I'm going to convert it to minor. So the guitar lick will be in F minor, and we'll move it around the neck a little bit as well and, you know, talk about that aspect. But the other thing that I'm going to do here, or coming up next on Patreon, is I'm going to take a look at setting up a scale pattern on the neck, and we're going to be working in minor, and I'm going to set you up with a jam track progression and teach you how to go about creating your own guitar licks, your own original licks and lines, because that's probably one of the most, you know, valuable things that you can practice and work on in your playing, because some of those licks that you'll invent, they're going to be probably your favorite and most, you know, coolest sounding licks that you're ever going to play. So I hope to catch up with you next on Patreon. One more time, the address is patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And if you need extra help with your guitar playing, maybe you want to study a full-on course. Maybe you're a beginner and you need to find out how the guitar works from the ground up. I've got a great beginner's program. I've got an intermediate guitar course as well. I've even got an advanced guitar program. It's all part of my core curriculum on my main website. It's a different website than Patreon. That address is going to be creativeguitarstudio.com. And over there, you're going to find all my core curriculum courses, like I just mentioned. And there's a bunch of elective guitar courses over there too, like my really popular acoustic guitar program. I've got my guitar soloing course, guitar technique, rhythm guitar, the songs program. And all these courses that I have, they're really detailed. There's tons of videos and they're literally like, you know, many hours long, lots of information, handouts, MP3 jam tracks. Like I say, it's really kind of like my life's work of guitar lessons that I put together and, you know, put on the website. So anyway, guys, if you need instruction, if you have to get things together, that's the website to really do it on. It's creativeguitarstudio.com. It's my official website for my lessons. But the part two video for this lesson here can be found on my Patreon. And that address, one more time, is patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you're going to get to watch a bonus video for the second half of this lesson. And in the bonus part two video, I'm going to take the lesson's guitar lick and do two important next step ideas with it. The first thing is I'm going to convert the lick from major tonality over to the natural minor. Then we're going to play a scale shape that I've laid out for you on the guitar neck so that you can start using it to create your own original guitar licks using a custom jam track progression that I've composed and recorded just for this lesson. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that stuff, you're going to get a bonus video and you're going to get jam tracks. And on top of that, you're going to get to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon and become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members' discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.